Hello dear students, welcome to transmission and distribution class. In the previous class we have seen the advantages and disadvantages and comparison of the DC and AC transmission. Let us see the advantages of high voltage transmissions. In the previous classes we have seen why we are going for the given that in AC transmission it is very easy to go for the high voltage and step up and step down is easy in the case of AC transmission. Then what is the need of for going the high voltage AC? That we will see one by one. So advantages of high voltage transmission is, first one is the reduces the volume of the conductor. Let P be the power transmitted in watts, V be the line voltage in volts, power factor is cos phi, L is the length of the line in the meters, R is the resistance per conductor in ohms, and rho is the resistivity of the conducting material, and A is the area of the cross section of the conductor. Let us see. We know that power is equal to P is equal to root 3 VI cos phi in the three phase system. So I can write I is equal to P by root 3 V cos phi. Coming to the resistance, we know that resistance is directly proportional to the length of the conductor and inversely proportional to the area of the conductor, and the proportionality constant is nothing but resistivity. So I can write R is equal to rho L by A. Total power loss W is given by 3 I square R, where I can replace with the equations that I got in the previous step, and in place of R I am putting the rho L by A. So after substitution and simplifying, 3 get cancels, and the total power loss W is going nothing but P square rho L by V square cos phi A. Area of the cross section A can be given by rearranging this equation, taking A to LHS and losses to the RHS side, that to the denominator. So I can write A is equal to P square rho L by W V square cos square phi. So this is the area of the cross section. Then total volume is given by 3AL for three phases. So A is area, L is the length into 3. So it is going to give a equation 3 P square rho L square divided by W V square cos square phi, where V is the voltage. You can see here, if the voltage V is high, the volume is less. If V is lesser, volume is more. So for the constant power, constant resistivity, constant current and constant losses, we can have the higher voltage can reduce the volume of the our conductor. Coming to the second point, it is going to increases the transmission efficiency. So first point is what? It is going to increase decrease the copper volume. Second one is increase the transmission efficiency. Input power is given by output power P plus total losses. P plus the total losses which we are got from the previous simplifications. So let us assume in current density. Current density is nothing but current per area. J is equal to J I by A, or the area is given by I by J. So I can rewrite the equation of input power where the area is there, that A is going to replace by I by J. So A is in the denominator, that's why J is coming to numerator and I is there in the denominator. So now in the place of A, I am replacing it by I by J. Now we are going to simplify this equation. So in the place of I, we can put P by root 3 V cos phi. So because I is in the denominator, root 3 V cos phi is coming to numerator and P is coming to the denominator. After simplifying, the total input power is given by P into 1 plus root 3 J rho L by V cos phi. Then transmission efficiency. What is the transmission efficiency? Transmission efficiency is nothing but output power by input power, P by the input power which we got from the previous substitution. So PP get cancels, remaining is 1 by 1 plus root 3 J rho L by V cos phi. Or using the mathematical series expansion, we can write this 1 minus root 3 J rho L by V cos phi approximately. By seeing this equation, we can tell that as current density, resistivity and currents are constant, so by increasing the value of V, the 1 minus term is going to decrease. As 1 minus V, 1 minus term is going to decrease, so efficiency obviously increases. That's what, with going for high value of V, the second term is going to decreases. If second term is decreases, means efficiency is obviously increases. If second term is higher, means efficiency is decreases. That's what, we need to go for a high voltage, we will get the good efficiency. Next point, depending on the line drop. As we seen, IR is nothing but a line drop, or R is nothing but rho L by A. By seeing this one, in the place of I, or in the place of A, we will put the J by A, same current density equation. We can write line drop is nothing but rho L J, or the line drop, percentage line drop is given by rho J L divided by V into 100. If J, P and I are constant, that is current density, resistivity and currents are constant, the percentage of the drop decreases when transmission voltage is high. If V is high, then only drop is, or percentage drop is decreases. If V is low, obviously the drop is going to increases. So these are the advantages of having the high voltage transmission. Means if we are having the high voltage, means first it is going to increase the decrease the volume of the conductor. We can save the amount in the we can save the cost in the conductor. It increases the efficiency. Obviously, it is very one of the required one. If we are going with a efficient system, we will get the good beneficial at the end. And if line drops are less, the regulation of the voltage also increases. So for having the high voltage transmission, we are having the, these are the advantages in the power system. Then all the 3 points we are telling advantages only, there is no disadvantages. Then obviously if advantages are there, means there is a disadvantages also. So limitations of high voltage transmission is, first one is the increased cost of the insulating the conductor. This is one of the major cost. We can save the cost in the conductor, volume is decreased, volume is less, but the spacing is more, insulation for the higher voltage is high. So when high insulation of the voltage range is increases, means obviously cost of the insulation is also going to increase. Means what we can save there, we have to spend here also. So these two conditions we need to take. If we simply, we can't go for high voltage. If we are going for high voltage, means we require that much space, that much spacing between the conductors, that much insulations for the conductors. And the second point is the increased cost of the transformer, switchgears and other apparatus. Obviously, the transformer's cost are depending upon the voltage ranges, because transformer is also having its own insulators, own conductors, and its size all depending upon the voltages. Even switchgear and other equipments also depend, its cost is depending upon the voltage level. So obviously these costs are going to increase. Then simply we can't go for a high voltage, or simply we can't go for a low voltage. If we are going for low voltage, we can save in these two things, but which is transformers and insulation. But the copper is more, transmission losses are less, drops are more. So finally we need to go for a economic choice of a voltage where the reliable operations we can achieve. Okay, this is regarding your advantages of high voltage transmission as well as limitations of the high voltage transmission. If you find any doubts, you can ask the question in our WhatsApp group. And if you are not finding any things, you can call me personally also. So after this whole unit, I am going to provide you the notes, okay? And probably I have finished all the theory parts first. We will keep the problems later. Thank you.